Greetings, happy campers. It is I, Jim3PO, and this week's theme is Creation Station. We will be making our very own droids. Now, R2, where is that blue saber? I disagree. I don't think we'll ever find it. Easy for you to say. We'll be doomed to use Elmer's for the rest of our days. Goodness, I found it! It was in your droid food bowl!
But first, a fun fact.
Did you know that Star Wars could not exist without puppets? No, those are Muppets. I mean puppets.
Every Star Wars movie, especially the old ones, are crawling with them.
The voice and puppeteer behind Miss Piggy also performed Yoda.
Lying, you are not. True, it is.
Frank Oz has been bringing Yoda to life ever since The Empire Strikes Back.
And did you know who else was a puppet?
Rancor?
You bet.
Sure are you? The Wampa is?
Definitely.
Salacious Crumb?
Was there even any doubt?
Puppet Jabba is not.
Without a doubt, 100% puppet. In fact, Jabba took 6 puppeteers to operate.
Impressive that is.
And even now, with all the technology we have, directors are still going to puppeteers for help. So hopefully now you see the importance of puppets to Star Wars.
Baby Yoda?
Absolutely. May the puppeteers be with you.
Now let's remember our 3 rules for the project. Try your best. Remember, there's no perfect in making art. Be safe. Let's respect the materials and make sure that we're using them correctly. And be kind. Let's make sure our table's covered and ask for help when you need it.
Alright, time to get our supplies. First, you'll need to gather some recycled materials like paper towel tubes and yogurt cups. I have some colorful tape. This will be to give my droid color. Pipe cleaners are great because they look like wires. Googly eyes are great because they look like googly eyes. And I'll be using metallic markers for the design. And finally, some scissors and glue stick. This way I can cut the tape neatly and I can add glue to the googly eye. Now my first step is to kind of design this droid. So I'm gonna take my recycled materials and stack them in such a way so that I like how it looks. I'm going for kind of like a Star Wars looking droid. So I think these 3 parts make it awesome. So basically now I'm going to tape all my parts together. And I'm using color tape. So this way the color tape ends up being kind of like the design instead of having to paint it. So I'm just adding the tape to attach the paper towel tube. Now I'm going to cover the rest of my yogurt container with the blue tape and cover up that yogurt label. Once the bottom is done, I could do the same thing for the paper towel tube. In this case, I'm going to use red tape. And same thing for the top, but I'll be using white for the top. Remember, you guys can use any colors you want, and whatever color tape you have might dictate what colors you use. Hey, that looks pretty good. All right, now I'll use the pipe cleaner for wire. Notice how I'm spinning it around my finger. Wires are great to make something look like droids. And then I'll use a bit of tape to attach. Next, I'm going to use markers. I'm using these Crayola metallic markers because they're a bit more shiny, kind of droid-like. But remember, guys, you can use whatever you have on hand. Now, to make it look like a droid, I'm trying to draw mostly lines and geometric shapes. What are those? Well, like squares, rectangles, circles, and in this case, kind of these zigzag lines here. But remember, guys, this is your droid, so design it how you like. Now, I'm going to be adding some marker to my googly eye here. It will look more like R2-D2's eye, which is more of like a round screen. I did 2 googly eyes of different sizes, and now I'm just adding glue to attach them to the head. And wow, doesn't that look like a droid?
All right, guys, now I get to name it. This is QB12AYBAAA3. See you next time.